going to explain the second question of the exercise 4.1. Represent the following situations in the form of a quadratic equation. They are given few situations. You have to form a quadratic equation from the given situation. Only you have to form the quadratic equation. Okay? So listen how to form. First question is, area of a rectangular plot is 528 m². Area of a rectangular plot is given as 528 m². Now second condition is, length of the plot is 1 more than twice its breadth. Twice its breadth. That is the condition. It means we have one of the rectangular garden. Area of the rectangular garden is 528. Okay? Length is 1 more than twice the breadth. It means length is depending on breadth here. So first of all, I will assume the breadth. Breadth I assumed as x. Then if the breadth is x, if the breadth is x, then the length is equal to, see the condition, 1 more than twice its breadth. 1 more than twice means 2 times breadth. Breadth we assumed as x. One more time I will repeat. Here I assume the breadth of the rectangular garden as x, because in the statement the length we will be getting using breadth according to the given condition. It means length is depending on breadth here. So I assume the breadth first. Breadth I assumed as x. If the breadth is x, then the length is 1 more than twice its breadth. 2 times its breadth. So length we got it as 2x plus 1, and the breadth assumed as x. So here I am writing as 2x plus 1. Length is 2x plus 1 and the breadth is x. Therefore, area, we can write it as length into breadth. In smaller classes already you learned, area is equal to length into breadth. Area they are given as 528. So 528 is equal to length into breadth. 2x plus 1 into x. 2x plus 1 into x. It means 528 is equal to 2x into x. 2x square plus 1 into x. X. So I can write this as 2x square plus x. Now what I will do? I will bring these two words. Right hand side will become minus 528. That is equal to 0. I can write it 0 here or here. So this is the general form of a quadratic equation. So given situation, I express in the form of a quadratic equation. Okay. Now the second question is, product of two consecutive positive integers is 306. We have to represent this situation as a quadratic equation. Product of two consecutive positive integers. It means here we have to take the product of two integers. What is the product of two integers? That is 306. Which type of integers are here? The product of two consecutive positive integers. What is meant by consecutive numbers? The difference between the number is 1. If 1 and 2 are consecutive numbers. 3 and 5 are consecutive numbers. 10 and 11 are consecutive numbers. If I am taking the even numbers, 2 and 4 are the consecutive even numbers. 2 ke baad 4 aate hain. 2 and 4 are the consecutive even numbers. 4 and 6 are the consecutive even numbers. 10 and 12 are the consecutive even numbers. If I am taking about the consecutive odd numbers, 1 and 3 are consecutive odd numbers. 1 and 3 are consecutive odd numbers. 7 and 9 are consecutive odd numbers. Here they are talking about the positive integers. Means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, etc. These are the positive integers. Consecutive means 1 and 2. These two are consecutive. Whereas 2 and 3 are consecutive. 3 and 4 are consecutive. 5 and 6 are consecutive. Like 99 and 100 are consecutive. Then, in general, if I am writing one of the number as x, then what is the next number? One more than this. If one of the number is 1, then another number is 1 plus 1, 2. If one of the number is 2, then the another number is 2 plus 1, 3. Same way, here the next consecutive number is x plus 1. You have to add 1 with the previous number. So here x and x plus 1 are the consecutive numbers. Now what you have to do? You have to take the product of these two to get 306. That is the situation what they are given. So x into x plus 1 is equal to 306. Now you have to open the bracket. X into x, x square plus x into 1, x, which is equal to 306. Shift this constant towards left hand side. It becomes x square plus x minus 306 is equal to 0. So this is in the general form ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. This is the general form of a quadratic equation, where a is equal to 1, b is equal to 1 and c is minus 306. Next question is, Rohan's mother is 26 years older than him. Product of their age 3 years from now will be 360. Represent this situation in the form of a quadratic equation. Here, they are talking about the product of the age 3 years from now of whom? Of Rohan and his mother. So here, about Rohan's age, they not mentioned anything. So we will assume Rohan's age as x. Let Rohan's age be x. If Rohan's age is x, then Rohan's mother's age is 26 years older than him. It means Rohan's mother's age will be 26 years more than Rohan's age. So Rohan's mother's age will be x plus 26. Jo bhi Rohan ka age hai, uske saath humko 26 add karna hai. We need to add 26 with Rohan's age because it is given that Rohan's mother is 26 years older than him. Now, we need to take the product of these two. But one situation is there. 3 years from now, means after 3 years, they will be having 3 years more than the present age. You need to take the product of that age. So, after 3 years, Rohan will be x plus 3 and Rohan's mother after 3 years her age will be 3 more than the present age. It means x plus 26 is the present age. With this age you have to add 3. then it will be x plus 26 plus 3, which is 29. This portion, is it clear or no? Because only this portion, some way will be having confusion. One more time I will repeat. Rohit's present age is x. And Rohit's mother is 26 years older than Rohit. It means mother's age will be 26 more than Rohit's age. Now we are talking about the age after 3 years. After 3 years means our age will be increasing by 3. So here also Rohit's and mother's age increase by 3. At present Rohit's age is x. So after 3 years Rohit's age will be x plus 3. At present Rohit's mother's age is x plus 26. So after 3 years Rohit's mother's age will be 3 more than the present age. It means we have to add 3 with this. X plus 26 plus 3. X plus present age of Rohan is X plus, sorry, Rohan's mother is X plus 26. You have to add 3 with this age. Then mother's age will be X plus 29. This is Rohan's mother's age after 3 years. Now what we have to do? We have to take the product of this. Product of their age after 3 years is 360. It means we need to take the product of these two. Which two? After 3 years Rohan's age and mother's age. We need to take the product of these two ages. So x plus 3 is Rohan's age after 3 years. X plus 29 is the mother's age after 3 years. Product of these two is equal to 360, they are given. So we need to take the product of these two. So I am going to write this portion, okay. Now the same equation I have written here. Now you have to open the bracket. X into x, x square. X into 29, 29x. 3 into x, 3x. Plus 3 into 29, 87. That is equal to 360. Now 360 you bring towards left hand side. X square plus 29 plus 3, that will be 32x plus 87 minus 360. 87 minus 360 will become minus 273. So this plus will become minus. Minus 273, that is equal to 0. So here we got the given situation in the form of a quadratic equation. Got it? Now I am going to explain the fourth question. A train travels a distance 480 km at a uniform speed. If the speed had been 8 km per hour less, then it would have taken 3 hours more to cover the same distance. We need to find the speed of the train. This is the situation they are given. We have to frame the quadratic equation. So here, distance travelled by a train is 480 km. Distance is 480. And the speed was uniform. Uniform means same speed from starting to end. The speed they are not given. But one condition they are given. What is the condition? If the speed had been 8 km per hour less, 8 km per hour less, then it would have been taken 3 hours more to cover the same distance. Agar train ki speed, jo constant speed hai, usse 8 किलोमीटर पर आवर कम होते तो ट्रेन 3 घंटा और ज्यादा लेते, क्योंकि स्पीड कम होगा तो टाइम ज्यादा होगा. अगर हम धीरे चलेंगे तो टाइम बहुत ज्यादा लगेंगे. तो यहां का कंडीशन क्या है? डिस्टेंस ट्रैवल्ड बाय ट्रेन इज 480 किलोमीटर. एक ट्रेन 480 किलोमीटर डिस्टेंस कवर किया. नेक्स्ट कंडीशन क्या है? स्पीड अगर 8 किलोमीटर का पर आवर ज्यादा लेते. एक्चुअल टाइम है सो दे आर नॉट गिवन. सो हियर आई विल अस्यूम द यूनिफॉर्म स्पीड एज एक्स. इफ वी नो द डिस्टेंस एंड द स्पीड देन यू नो हाउ टू कैलकुलेट द टाइम. टाइम इज इक्वल टू डिस्टेंस बाय स्पीड. सो हियर फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई विल अस्यूम द स्पीड एज एक्स किलोमीटर पर आवर. एक घंटे में एक्स किलोमीटर, दैट इज द असम्पशन दैट आई अस्यूम. नाउ द टोटल डिस्टेंस कवर्ड दैट इज इक्वल टू 480. दिस इज द डिस्टेंस कवर्ड बाय द ट्रेन. नाउ वी नो दैट द टाइम इज इक्वल टू डिस्टेंस बाय स्पीड. डिस्टेंस बाय स्पीड इज टाइम. ओके नाउ फर्स्ट वी विल कैलकुलेट द टाइम टेकन बाय द ट्रेन इफ द स्पीड इज एक्स किलोमीटर पर आवर. देन द टाइम टेकन बाय द ट्रेन दैट आई एम टेकिंग एज टी वन, क्योंकि यहां दो टाइम निकालने जा रहे हैं. सो फर्स्ट टाइम आई एम टेकिंग एज टी वन. ये कंडीशन क्या है? ट्रेन का स्पीड एक्स किलोमीटर पर आवर है एंड द टोटल डिस्टेंस इज 480. देन द टाइम इज इक्वल टू डिस्टेंस बाय स्पीड. टोटल डिस्टेंस कवर्ड इज 480 एंड द स्पीड इज एक्स. नाउ द कंडीशन व्हाट दे आर सेइंग, इन द कंडीशन दे आर सेइंग दैट इफ द स्पीड इज 8 किलोमीटर पर आवर लेस. पहले के स्पीड से 8 किलोमीटर पर आवर स्पीड कम है तो पहले का स्पीड कितना था? एक्स. 8 किलोमीटर कम है मतलब x माइनस 8. ओके सो नाउ द स्पीड इज x माइनस 8, क्योंकि पहले के स्पीड से 8 किलोमीटर पर आवर लेस. इट मींस फर्स्ट एट फर्स्ट द स्पीड वाज x, नाउ द स्पीड इज x माइनस 8. वी हैव टू रिड्यूस इट बिकॉज द स्पीड इज रिड्यूसिंग हियर. इट इज 8 किलोमीटर पर आवर लेस. नाउ at first if the speed was 20 and it is reduced by 8 means 20 minus 8 12. At first if the speed was 100 and if it is reduced by 8 means 100 minus 8 92. Like at first if the speed was x kilometer per hour then now the speed is x minus 8. New speed is x minus 8. But the distance is same only, distance is not changing. So time taken this time, it means the second time. According to second condition, I am writing the time. So time taken is equal to distance by speed, that is equal to 480 by this speed. The speed is x minus 8. Here we got two times. One is this one, when the speed was x kilometer per hour, then time taken is equal to total distance covered divided by the speed. Second one, when the speed reduced by 8 kilometer per hour, then time t2 is equal to total distance covered by x minus 8. Now what we have to do? Just to see what it is given. When the speed, if the speed had been 8 km per hour less than, then it would have been taken 3 hours more. After speed 8 km per hour kam hote, to train 3 ghanta aur jyada lete distance cover karne ke liye. It means, if the time taken at first is, for example, 10 hours, okay, at first the time taken is 10 hours. Then, after reducing the speed, it has taken 10 plus 3, 13 hours. Another example, If the time taken at first is 5 hours, then the according to second condition, if the speed is 8 km/h, then the time taken will be 3 hours more. It means 5 + 3 = 8. Like here, we don't know about the time and all. We got the time in this way. These are the times. This is the time taken at first when the speed was x km/h, and this is the time taken when the speed has 8 km/h less than the previous speed. Now see, I am going to find the difference between the time. Difference between the time is 3 hours. That is given in the condition. क्योंकि स्पीड कम होते तो 3 घंटा ज्यादा लेते. इट मींस द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द स्पीड टाइम एट फर्स्ट एंड द टाइम नाउ दैट इज 3 hours. सो टाइम टेकन नाउ माइनस द टाइम टेकन एट फर्स्ट दैट इज इक्वल टू 3 hours. व्हाई आई डिड इन दिस वे, दिस इज द टाइम टेकन नाउ. व्हाई? Because now only the time has taken more. Because if the speed is less, then the time will be more. So here, speed is x minus 8. So this time the time has taken more. So from this time, I am subtracting the previous one. This is the time taken when the speed was x. And this is the time taken when the speed was x minus 8. अगर speed कम है तो time ज्यादा लेंगे, अगर speed ज्यादा है तो time कम लेंगे. मतलब time is more here. That more time has taken here when the speed is less. So t2 minus t1 is equal to 3. t2 is 480 by x minus 8 minus 480 by x. That is equal to 3. According to the situation, here I framed another equation. Now only we have to solve this equation. So that equation I have written here. Okay. Now 480 is there in both the terms. I will take it common. 480 I will take common. Then here 1 by x minus 8 minus 1 by x will be there. That is equal to 3. Now I take the LCM. 480 will be outside. Here x minus 8 into x. That will be the LCM. Above. The x will go here. X minus of x minus 8. That is equal to 3. So 480 multiplied by x minus x, that will cancel. Now minus minus 8 will become 8. Only 8 will remain in the numerator. Here x into x, x square minus 8x will be there. That is equal to 3. Now I will cross multiply. So here numerator will be 480 into 4. That is equal to x square minus 8x multiplied by 3. So the equation will become 480 into 8. 480 into 8, that is equal to x square minus 8x multiplied by 3. X square minus 8x multiplied by 3. Okay. 480 I multiplied with the numerator and denominator, whatever term was there, that I multiplied with the constant. Cross multiplication. Now what? You have to multiply 480 with 8. If you are multiplying 480 with 8, then you will be getting 3840. That is equal to 3x square minus 24x. 8 3s are 24. Now bring in the standard form. 3x square minus 24x. This also shifting. Minus 3840. That is equal to 0. You can keep in this way. Otherwise, see here. All these terms can be divided with 3. So you can write in the simplest form. So it will be x square minus of 8x minus 1, 2, 8, 0. So the equation become x square minus 8x minus 1280 equal to 0. This is the equation. I know this question, it is little bit difficult to understand. Only difficulty level is in framing the equation. If you want, I will explain one more time. Listen. Here, the difference between the time is 3 hours. From where it came? At first, it was given that when the speed was uniform, okay, t1 was the time taken. That is our assumption. Distance traveled by a train is 480. And that speed we assumed as x kilometer. Then, the time taken at first, that is equal to 480 by x, because distance traveled by, covered by a train is 480, and the time, the speed is x. So the time taken is equal to distance divided by speed. What was the second condition? If the speed could have been 8 km per hour less, अगर स्पीड पहले के स्पीड से 8 किलोमीटर पर अवर कम होते तो 8 किलोमीटर पर अवर कम होते तो इट मींस द प्रेजेंट स्पीड इज x माइनस 8 किलोमीटर पर अवर कम इट मींस x माइनस 8 पहले के स्पीड से 8 किलोमीटर पर अवर कम करना इट मींस यू हैव टू सब्ट्रैक्ट इट लेकिन इस टाइम पे डिस्टेंस सेम है द डिस्टेंस इज 480 ओके सो The second time when the speed is reduced, then t2 is equal to total distance, that is 480 only, divided by the new speed. New speed is 8 km per hour less than the previous speed. Ab next condition kya bola tha? Agar speed kam hoga to pehle se 3 ghanta aur jyada lenge. मतलब पहले जितना भी टाइम लिया था उससे 3 घंटा ज्यादा लेंगे मतलब कब ज्यादा लिया दूसरी बार कितना ज्यादा लिया 3 घंटा ज्यादा लिया मींस यहां टाइम ज्यादा लिया कितना ज्यादा लिया 3 घंटा ये जो टाइम है पहले के टाइम से 3 घंटा ज्यादा लिया पहले के टाइम मतलब t1 था उससे 3 घंटा और ज्यादा लिया कब यहां दूसरी बार तो यहां से इक्वेशन फ्रेम होते हैं इट मींस ये t1 को यहां लेके आ जाओ देन t2 शिफ्ट हियर दिस t1 माइनस t1 दैट इज इक्वल टू 3 t2 एंड t1 आर t2 इज 480 बाय x माइनस 8 एंड t1 इज 480 बाय x जस्ट यू हैव टू पुट इन दिस equation and solve it. Already I shown how to solve one. I hope it is clear now.